Deputy Chairman sir, for giving me the opportunity to participate in this debate. Sir, before I start, I would like to follow the ethics and I would like to disclose that I am associated with a private school.
Okay. Now you can proceed. Yes.
Sir, the RTI Act is in operation from last 7 years. It is one of the landmark legislation which the Parliament has passed in the recent years. After amending the Constitution under Article 21A, this legislation was essential and the Parliament unanimously passed this legislation. It is time for us to review its implementation. 7 years is quite a considerable time for any program, plan to review, and this is the right time, though the bill is only one clause is being amended to extend the training period from 31st March 2015 to 31st March 2020. There itself, it is one of the failures. Now to overcome the failure, we are bringing this amendment. Now, sir, this act has done a lot of good. Several achievements have been there. To say that there are no achievements is not correct. The important thing in this amendment of making the educational fundamental right is the burden of educating a child from 6 to 14 has been shifted primarily from the parents to the state. Today, it is the state responsibility to provide free, compulsory, and quality education to a child. And no child should be left over. It's not a single child should be left over, and the state is responsible and accountable. What does it want to achieve, sir? That both the state government and central government has been entrusted with the responsibility. Both are partners. Education is in concurrent list. It is the responsibility of the center, it is the responsibility of the state. So nobody can escape the responsibility. Now, let us see whether the act which is in operation from 7 years, how far we have succeeded, how far we have failed, and how we can overcome the failure. Sir, there are several responsibilities imposed on the state and the central government under the Act. The first and major responsibility is survey of neighborhood. Because only through survey of neighborhood children, the state will come to know how many children are available there who are to be educated, who are from the deprived section of the society, from scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, OBC. And this is through the panchayats they have to, that is the obligation under the Act. Sir, the Honorable Minister can apprise the House. 70% of the survey has not been taken place. 70% of the survey has not taken place. Then how do you implement this act? Today this act, pardon me if I say that this act is implemented not with love and affection, but taking the cooperation of everybody. It is to the power of the state which is being implemented, which you cannot succeed. I remember, sir, while this bill was being debated in this house, I had said, then it was UPA government, even then I had cautioned the HRD minister, it is a responsibility of, as my colleague Mr. Derek said, there are five partners in this. He said, what, five P's? Whatever. So there are five stakeholders also while educating these students. What is the responsibility in the act you have done? Where is the cooperation of all these people? There is nothing. There is no, except a school management committee. The parents are not involved in finding out whether, in assessing what is this thing. The schools are not involved. The managements are not involved. What is involved is black development of black education officer, state government. If you go on reality, if you go to the ground reality, it is total. I had spoken four years back when the bill was being debated. Today I have no hesitation repeating. There is full of corruption as far as I can tell you of my state. At the block officer, because today the 25% reservation in private school is for deprived section of the society. You take a survey today by money, power and dollar, because the private school fees is very high. Now, it is a racket through black development officer, black education officer, to get the seats in the private school through online this. Whereas the responsibility given is to make a survey and assess the deprived children in the neighborhood locality. And then the act has given the defining the neighborhood. Every year the state will be changing the neighborhood. One day it say 1 kilometer, another day is 4 kilometers, the third year they say 10 kilometers, and then after that the entire area, there is no neighborhood. Yeah, the entire city is a neighborhood. So this is will not achieve the purpose. The private schools are playing a very important role in your system. Some may not be good, because there are black sheep in every system. They are providing you lakhs and lakhs of free seat. Where are they involved? Where the suggestion is taken? Who will study their problems? There is a conflict between the CBSE and the state. CBSE school issue one circular, state issue one circular. So you would not like to take into consideration the problems of private school when you take so much of seats from them with free, and you have not found out whether the state government has reimbursed their fees or not is not known. Yes, it is a social obligation. Private schools has to take this responsibility. But discuss with them. Find out how much more effective they can implement this provisions of right to compulsory education. There is absolutely no say for the private schools in the entire implementation of the RTA Act, whereas they are the biggest contributor for you. Then comes the fee structures. It is obvious, it is a common sense. 25% of the seat of the private institution you are taking away. Yes, it is an obligation. But at the same time, while taking into consideration their problems are also to be, when they are contributing 25% of their this one, how they are compensated, how their problems are looked into. There is no committee of the private schools and the government. The state government is not consulting. The state government is looking this private management who are giving 25% of the seat, which is some several lakhs of seat, which the honorable minister knows the correct figure. And they are looked at as thieves by the state governments, by the bureaucracy. So you have left everything at the lurch of the bureaucracy, and whatever they decide is decided. There is no involvement of anybody. I request the honorable minister, the CBSE has a great role to play. CBSE, there should be some consistency. CBSE should have consultation with the private schools because they have the largest number of schools in the country, CBSE. How can CBSE just say we have no responsibility, just issue circular and keep quiet? Then comes to financial aspect. Now, what we have now at present, the best reviews is by the CAG report. Now, the CAG report has just been laid on the floor of the parliament. Now, what does it say? I am just conclusion, I will say. The CAG says, conclusion, there is no separate budget for RTE. And it is subsumed in SSA, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan budget. How can it be? How can you achieve the RTA objective when you are just made it a part of a big Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan? The AWP and B was not used as an input for budgeting exercise in Government of India and states. The unspent balance at the end of the year did not match with the opening balance of the succeeding year for all during 2010 to 2016. As per the utilization certificate by the MHRD, there was persistent closing balance and advances pending, cases of diversions, irregular release of funds, misappropriation of funds, irregular utilization of grant, irregular depiction in annual accounts of SIS, and delay in releasing the funds at various levels. This is the conclusion of the CAG as far as the utilization of the fund. I mentioned about the survey. The CAG also has commented. As per rule 10 of the RTA rules, the local authority shall maintain a record of all children in its jurisdiction through a household survey from their birth till they attain the age of 14. The record is to be updated annually, maintained in public domain. Audit noted that regular household survey was conducted to record and update the information of all children up to age of 14 in 14 states, UTs, while no such regular survey was conducted in remaining 21 states and UTs. Since the household survey was not carried out, vital information, number of children in age group of 0 to 14, number of children attending the school, out of school children have not been captured up to annually. Sir, poor retention rate in government school. Have we discussed about this problem? After the RTA is introduced, the private schools are giving 25%, whereas the retention, the government schools are closing. No children, and there is huge retention of in private schools as per the CAG. And then have huge dropouts in government schools. The very purpose of this act is to remove, to tackle the dropout. They say analysis of UDSA data dropout percentage for a period of 4 years is tabulated. So the highest in government schools, they drop out. the schools, government schools conditions. Every government school should have certain infrastructure under the act. It is mandatory. Nobody has surveyed whether all the government school has got that minimum infrastructure. It talks about minimum infrastructure. There is no minimum infrastructure in most of the school. Only 50% of the schools has got electricity. 50% of the schools have no electricity. Out of 10,75,000 government managed schools, only 6,23,000 schools have electricity and 4,00,000 schools have no electricity. What I am telling you, sir, these are mentioned in the act, implementation of the act. It is not the minimum infrastructure, physical infrastructure and teachers. It is responsibility of the government, in the government school. If you don't provide infrastructure in the government school, how do you expect the children to go to government school? You are depriving the parents. All private schools cannot take, so you are doing discrimination. Only one or two children will, people who are influenced or who can go to the private under 20% quota. But what about 75% of the children? Where do they go? What type of education? What type of quality education you are giving? Sir, so my suggestion, Honorable Minister, is that let it be the involvement, public involvement, stakeholders' involvement, and the private schools' involvement. There should be some thing which it is the duty of all of us, private school, public school, it is duty of all of us. So this is time for taking stock of the RTA Act. This is one of the landmark legislation. Let us really make that people will feel that this is the legislation which changed the destiny of the nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Rahman Saab.
Thank you, sir.